says it's inevitable that, that the scam's going to be late between 6 and 12 months, Labor says. Is that something that Labor accepts?
No, we don't. I think it's absolutely critical that all of us, all governments, the providers, people with disability, families, do everything we possibly can to make sure that the National Disability Insurance Scheme is rolled out on time. People with disability have waited all their lives to get decent services, and the last thing we want is any delay. I was very pleased to see the Minister, Christian Porter, this morning say that he will not be renegotiating the agreements. He too understands that it's important to make sure this scheme is delivered on time.
Given the problems that we've seen in the first year of transition, what changes do you say need to be made so that A, those timeframes are met, but B, that the quality improves markedly from what we've seen?
I think that's a very important point. First of all, let's look at what the Productivity Commission itself recommended. It acknowledged that one of the reasons for the problems that people are having getting into the National Disability Insurance Scheme is that there just aren't enough staff, there aren't enough well-trained staff to actually make sure that people get into the scheme, get in on time, and get good plans. So first and foremost, this government has to lift the cap that they have imposed on the staffing for the National Disability Insurance Scheme. We need to make sure there are enough staff in the National Disability Insurance Agency and that the staff are well trained. We need the first plans to be good plans. We certainly don't want any more over the phone planning. It's meant lots and lots of mistakes, more reviews, people having to come back, and of course that clogs up the system. The other huge problem, which is the responsibility of this government, is the mess they have made with the IT system. We know that when it first came in, there hadn't been any live testing before it started. Right from the beginning, there were problems for people with disability and families and providers. Huge problems, and basically the system hasn't been able to catch up since. So fix the problems with the IT system and take the cap off the staffing for the National Disability Insurance Agency.
Obviously, you and the government say that those timeframes should stay as they are. But should states especially plan for the contingency if there are delays so that people don't fall through the gaps between their current services and the NDIS?
Well, we certainly should make sure that the states don't exit the field, don't stop providing services to people with disability before they come into the National Disability Insurance Scheme. We have heard reports that some states are not meeting their obligations, not actually continuing to provide support where they should be. The other big problem that's been identified both by the Productivity Commission and by many people in the community is that there are lots of issues with people with disability who have health problems, for example, the health system trying to cost shift onto the National Disability Insurance Scheme. We don't want the states or the Commonwealth, for that matter, cost shifting onto the National Disability Insurance Scheme. And it really is the responsibility of this government to work with the states to make sure that they continue to provide adequate services in health, education, justice, transport, all those basic services that are primarily the state's responsibility. They should not be cost-shifting onto the NDIS.
The report, one of the concerning elements of the report, was just the sluggishness that's increasing the workforce to be up to the 170,000, I think it is, that will be needed when the scheme's fully rolled out. Would Labor support short-term skilled migration changes to help remedy that?
I think that would be incredibly disappointing. This is a huge opportunity for job growth in Australia, for Australians. And once again, what has this government been doing to actually make sure that the opportunities for employment that are being created through the introduction of the National Disability Insurance Scheme, anything from 60 to 90,000 new jobs, make sure Australians can get those jobs by getting out there, increasing the opportunities in TAFEs and universities, making sure that school leavers understand the opportunities, that university graduates understand the opportunities that are being created in the National Disability Insurance Scheme. So this federal government has a responsibility to develop a workforce strategy. It's way overdue. Get your act together and make sure Australians can get these jobs.
Surely over the next 1 or 2 years, the skilled professions like speech therapists, occupational therapists, where qualifications are needed, and you simply just can't get those qualifications in the period to fill that gap.
But once again, what has this government been doing? They've been in government now for more than 4 years. They knew that this was a huge opportunity for Australians to get these extra 60, 70, 80,000 new jobs. Get active, get people encouraged to come into disability care and support. They're fantastic jobs working with people with disability. We want to make sure that Australians get the chance to get these jobs.
If it was a question of a person getting services or not getting services, because it's a skilled migrant coming to the country, who would you see?
Well, I just reinforce again, I want Australians to get these jobs. There are plenty of people who want to work in the disability field. Let's make sure we do everything possible to provide these opportunities for Australians to get these jobs.
Just lastly, the reinforcing the quality of plans has been substandard, and even saying this morning that the planning process has been literally traumatic for some people with psychosocial disabilities. Just on that point, the fact that this is causing trauma for some people.
It is a serious concern, and I've heard it a lot, and of course there were very serious issues raised on 7:30 last night on the ABC with families saying how difficult this has been for them. So yes, it's true for people with psychosocial issues, but it's also true for people with other disabilities, and it's not good enough. It is not good enough. We have to make sure that the plans are of high quality. This is driven by there not being enough staff in the National Disability Insurance Agency. They do have to meet the demands of people who want to come into the scheme. That is a good thing, but to have good plans, there needs to be enough well-trained staff. So the government needs to lift the cap that they imposed on the staffing for the National Disability Insurance Agency.